Welcome back. In the last class, we have discussed about normal distribution concept, its meaning, and why we are using normal distribution. And we have been discussing about the properties with regard to that. Let us discuss with regard to the preparation of a normal curve in association with the normal distribution representation. Previously, we have discussed about normal distribution case. And in that explanation, we have mentioned that if you are representing any random experiment situation or a continuous random variable in a graphical form, you will get a histogram in which it will be the highest value in the middle and it will be diminishing in both sides. So this is how a normal distribution situation is represented in a graph. See, it almost looks like a bell. That is why it is known as a bell curve, where the highest value will be at the center, where mean, median, mode will be equal, and here it is in the highest value, where mean value will be the highest. And if the same is represented in a graph, it will be a line, continuous line, just like this, where it is the highest value is in the middle and it keeps on diminishing in both sides. So it is how a normal distribution curve is looks like, and why it is called a bell curve like that. And previously mentioned that the curve is just like this, where one side is 50% of the certain value, here also 50% of the certain value, and the entire value, the mean, median and mode will be equal. And if you consider that the entire the value of this entire curve from this point to this point, we can assume that let it be 1, or if it is 100, this side represents 50% and this side represents 50%. This side is plus, this side is minus. And here, if you represented a value in terms of 1, the entire area or length of the in this point to this point will be 1. So the values within the graph is from this point, that is, this is represented as 0. 0 to this point is represented as 0.5. And from this point to this is known as 0.5. The difference is that this one is positive side and this one is negative side. And we have discussed about the scale of values or representation regarding if you are getting a standard deviation value 2, 1, 2 and 3 regarding 0.1, 0.2 and 0.3. That was the concept. We will discuss in detail during the application level situation. This is how a graph or a bell diagram with regard to a normal distribution looks like. It is symmetrical form. We have discussed that property with regarding to that. And we also discussed about this point also. See, the standard deviation 1 will be from this point, minus 1 to plus 1 is represented by 68% chance. That is, 68% of values are within one standard deviation of the mean. If you have got a value in between minus 2 and plus 2, the percentage chance is 95% of the value are within 2 standard deviations of the mean. If you have got 99.7% of values have between 3 standard deviations of the mean. So the value computation is like this. From this point onwards, right side 1, 2, 3, and from this point 1, 2, 3 likewise. So this is how the scale representation takes place. So let us go to our name in the main topic, normal distribution concept. Importance or uses of normal distribution. It has quite a lot of applications in commerce, science, economics and many other disciplines. Still, let us pinpoint some of the main uses of normal distribution. The discrete probability distribution such as binomial distribution and Poisson distribution tend to normal distribution as n becomes large. So that was one of the reason why normal distribution is given more preference when it comes to binomial distribution and Poisson distribution. When the value of n is large, normal distribution is useful. Almost all the sampling distributions will be represented in a normal distribution form because here the n values will be large. That is another reason why we are using normal distributions in place of Poisson distribution as well as binomial distribution. Many tests of significance are based on the assumption that parent population from which samples are drawn follow a normal distribution. You will not get an idea with regarding to that because it is actually a research oriented sentence. Many tests of significance are based on the assumption that parent population from which samples are drawn. So before we explain it at that point, you need to understand two terms: population and standard deviation. So population and samples. So what is meant by population? You may think that population is the demographical representation of a country or a region or an area. In research oriented view, population means the area under the study. For example, if you are studying about the percentage of pass mark among your friends in a class, that is known as population, because your class is the main topic under the study. There are no other subclass, there is only one class for you. There will be 50 or 60 students in a class, that entire students is represented as population. So whatever the standard study, that is known as population. And out of that population, you may take the details or some of the details of some student from boys or some student from girls. You are not going to study all the students. You are going to take some students. That is known as samples. So sample is something that we have chosen out of a population. Population means anything that comes under the study. So most of the research activities in which there will be population and there will be samples, and it will be represented in a normal distribution pattern. So normal distribution is of great importance. That is the meaning of the sentence. And with regard to a simple example, you will get a clear picture. If you are going to study the total consumers of the Maruti Suzuki cars in India, do you able to study the satisfaction or the customers, whatever it is? Are you going to interview all the Indians who have Maruti Suzuki car? Are you going to knock on their door and ask about the car? Or are you going to travel far away to all the customers all around the world, India? No, we can't. Because there are millions and millions of people, there are Maruti Suzuki customers. Then how you are going to do it? You are going to pinpoint some of the customers from a particular region. So the population represents whatever the entire population under the study, whatever the subject matter which you are going to study, the entire number of items is known as population. And from that population, you will be selecting some samples, because you aren't able to analyze all the details regarding the population if the population is large. If the population is small, we can do it, but if it is large, it is very difficult. That is a concept regarding population and samples. You will come across such terms during higher studies or at the subjects in research methodology based subjects like that. Anyway, understand the concept. The normal distribution has numerous mathematical properties which make it popular and comparatively easy to manipulate. It's a representation of almost all this type of analysis. It is represented in a class form, continuous form, many sorts of mathematical and further analysis is possible in case of a normal distribution. That is why it is more preferable when compared to a Poisson distribution and a normal binomial distribution. Normal distribution finds application in statistical quality control, otherwise known as SQC. SQC is of great importance in the modern context. And normal distribution helps in maintaining statistical quality control. We will discuss or we will study about that in the higher studies. We need not have to go further into that. Many distributions in social and economic data are approximately normal. It will be represented in a class form, 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, like that, because it will be represented like that. For example, birth, death are normal distributed. We can't study about how many populations and how many people in our country there died at the age of 1, died at the age of 2, died at the age of 3. How we are going to analyze and identify all these tremendous data? We can't. So we will be using a class form. 0, how many of these people or the citizens in our country died at the age between 0 to 10, likewise. So our representation will be meaningful, easy and understandable. And the analysis also will be easy to compute. That is the concept. Next one, area under normal standard curve, otherwise known as standard normal curve. How we are going to represent in a curve? In case of a normal distribution, probability is determined on the base of area. Area means area under normal curve. We have learned about a bell-shaped curve, that is known as normal curve. But the area which we have to calculate the ordinate of z scale, the scale to which standard deviation is attached, is called z scale. We will come to that. The equation of standard normal curve or standard normal distribution. We have learned this equation previously, x minus mu divided by standard deviation. This will be the equation we will be using while dealing with application level questions. For example, the variable x follows a normal distribution with mean 45 and standard deviation 10. Find the probability that it is greater than or equal to 60. You are asked to find the probability with regard to that. And the value of x is given 60. You have to make sure whether it is greater than or equal to 60. So x value is given. And the mean of the distribution is given. It is represented as mu. Standard deviation is also given. So it is very easy. Just substitute these values in the equation and you will get ...1.5. So the probability of x greater than or equal to is represented by 1.5 as per the normal distribution situation. So this is how you have to deal with a problem. This is a simple question, but anyway the concept and the base and the pattern of computation is almost similar. It varies depending upon the adjustment and cases which you are going to deal under the study. And in case of normal distribution, remember in each of the computations you may have to prepare a simple freehand curve of the bell-shaped normal curve depending upon the details given in the question. We will come to that part. So these are the various important uses, aspects and area of this under the study. Let us deal further with that. How to find the table value of z? So if you go through the next previous question, you see that the value of z is 1.5. That is a probability term with regard to the z. And the thing is, that is not the exact probability value of z. You have to find the exact value of z on the basis of standard normal curve table that representing z distribution. There is a table with regarding to that. If you have the text, just refer to the table that is represented in the back of the text. If it is not there, please try a basic logarithm table where you can see the heading of the table will be area under standard normal curve for given x values. That is a title. So go through that table, and from that table you need to identify the exact value of the z. So here 1.5, even though it is correct, you have to find the exact value based on the table representation of standard normal curve of z. So 1.5. With some examples, we will discuss about how to compute the value of the z term from the table. How you are going to deal that. So let us try some of the cases. How to find the table values of z? How we are going to find? Once you found out the value on the base of simple equation, you need to identify the table value of that particular term. So how you are going to find it? So with some of the example we will discuss, then you will get a clear picture. For example, you have come across a question and you have arrived at a value where z equal to 1.25. So how we are going to find the value of the z on the base of standard normal curve table? That is the final answer. How you are going to find it? So 1.25. The thing is that first of all, take out the back side of your text or a logarithm table where you will see the title of the table as area under standard normal curve for given values of x. Take that table and you can see that first you will see certain numbers that is returned from the top to bottom in the left hand side of the column, and also you can see that in the top left corner of the table there will be a variable x, and to the right of that x you will see another set of row representing in a certain numbers in decimal form. With an example you will get a clear picture. So first of all, start on the left hand side of table, go down to 1.2. so this is just a part of the table, it is not a complete table. For the examples explanation only, I'm showing this case. Our value was 1.25. I have mentioned that there is a z in the top left corner of the table, and it is followed by certain decimal numbers 0.0, 0.1, 0.2. Like that, it will keeps on going until 3.9 in some text, and depending upon the size of the text, the value varies. And see, from right side you can see that 0.0, 0.01, 0.2. Here the numbers will be representing in the second position from the decimal. Here the numbers are represented from the first position from the decimal. That is the concept. So how we are going to deal with a value 1.25? So remember, you need to split this 1.25 into two parts. That is, the first numbers to the left and right of the decimal. So first numbers to the left and right is 1.2. Take 1.2 in the first column that is represented as z. You can see that 1.2 is here. See, 1.2. And note down the row in which the 1.2 stands. And next one. At the top bottom of the table, go to 0.05. And why it is that? 1.25 cannot be directly computed from a z table. It has to be split into two parts. One is 1.2 and another is 0.05. See, you can see that the numbers shown in the right side of the z, that is the row representing the z, you can see that all the numbers are beginning only after the second position from the decimal. See, 0.01, 0.02, 0.03. See, the first point in the right side of the decimal is 0. And why it is like that? Because when 1.25 is just like a case like that, if you want to find the value of 1.25, 1.2 has to be taken first. After that, you need to find 0.05. So if you add 1.2 and 0.05, you will get 1.25. That is a concept of finding the value of certain z value on the base of table. So find 0.05. See, here it is 0.05, and the point where 1.2 and 0.05 intersect is the value of the z based on the standard normal curve representing the z table. So here the value is 0.394. So the value in the table is 0.3944, which is the probability. But if this can be represented in a percentage, just multiply it with 100, you will get 39.44. So this is how you have to interpret the z value on the base of your computation by analyzing the z table. I hope you have understand the concept. Let us discuss another case similar to that. For example, if you have gone through an application question, and after the basic mathematical computation you have arrived at a value where z equals 1, how you are going to deal with if the value of certain value is z? So just like the method which I have mentioned previously, we first of all start with the left side of the table and go down to find 1.0. Here it is 1.0, let it be 1.0. So if you go through the table, you can see that here left side of the table 1.0, here it is 1.0. So mark it down 1.0, and you can see that after the decimal there is nothing. There is nothing means only zeros. So after decimal is represented as 0.00 or 0.0. You have to go through that particular column based on the second row. See, here it is the second row where you can see that the 0.00 is only value that comes the first. So point where the 1.0 and 0.00, if you add these headings, you will get the value 1.00. That is the value we have got. So the point where these two intersect is 0.3413. So the value of z probability, or the probability of z value of 1, is represented as 0.3413, which can be represented in a percentage form, which is known as 34.13%. So this is how you have to identify and find out the value of z on the base of table representation of z values. I hope you understand the concept. This is how you have to find the value of z out of the table. And it is also important to keep in mind that if you have a negative z score, you can simply use a table that contains negative z score. If you come across a question where you got -1.25, don't worry about the sign. Just compute the find out the value on the base of usual signs and put the sign of the particular number, whatever it is. If it is plus, show it as a plus value. That is, if it is a plus, show plus 3.9 0.3944. If it is a negative value, show it as -0.3944. likewise, that is the concept. There is a separate table for the computation of negative table, but as per the year syllabus, there is no further computation regarding that. So understand and familiarize these cases, and on the base of these theoretical concepts which we have been discussing for 2 or 3 days, we have to do some application level questions on the base of that. And please try to familiarize all these theoretical concepts, because during the application level question, you should have a thorough idea about the normal distribution concept, and you need to familiarize how to use the equation, how to find the table value on the base of z table, likewise. So just go through it. If you have any queries, please let me know.